Yeah, welcome everyone to our guided. Yeah, we have come closer, come really close. Cuddle, hug my avatar, do everything so that you can hear me better. So I'm really, really happy that you all came to our tour through the Liminal Latitudes exhibition space today. And first, I want to introduce you to the Kara Agora project, which Mara, who's also here, Mara and I co-founded with four other European curators this year. And it happened because a curator from Ukraine approached me and asked me, or said we could apply together for the European Cultural Solidarity Fund that funds cultural projects that create new public spaces across borders. And then we set up a team with six curators from Western and Eastern Europe to start this project. And we were really lucky to also have the to receive the grant money for the Kara Agora project, and that's how we started. And if you haven't visited it yet, there is like a main space of the whole projects, a project. There are four different projects. If you can see right behind me, there are these doors, like these portals, like the blue and the orange portal. I don't know if you can see it in the backside. There you can click on and then you can visit the main space, or you can do it later on via the website also. And yeah, Kara Agora is a mixed word of the Esperanto word Kara, which also derives from the Latin word for Kara, and Italian is the same word, and it means love or dear. And Agora, we all know, is the Greek marketplace where people met, where people traded, where people drank, where people had fun. And we combined these two words together, Kara Agora, Dear Agora, to create an online art and research center that connects across borders. And also language-wise, this title can be spoken very easily in many different languages, especially, of course, in the European ones. And yeah, Mara, Mara-Johanna Kolmel, she stands right next to me, her avatar, I hope you can see her. She curated on Instagram a great project which started during the lockdown and which was called Bunch of Kunst in Quarantine. Mara, what was the title again? Reflections on the virtual.
Reflections on the viral vacuum.
Right, thank you. Reflections on the viral vacuum. And she launched an open call and invited artists to send their works to her that deal with their situation, their feelings, the perception of the current corona crisis and the lockdown. And Mara presented all these wonderful works on her Instagram account. And in preparation for Kara Agora and for our show here, we were thinking about this project, and we were thinking to create a digital version out of this on Mozilla Hubs. And this is how, I will just maybe mute the sound. And this is how this project, Bunch of Kunst in Quarantine, with the Paradox Paradise edition, where you now stand in one of the two spaces, came into existence. And Mara and I selected, especially from her first Instagram project, European artists, because Kara Agora is a European project. And we selected almost 20 artists, and we challenged most of them to showcase their artworks that are actually made for the physical space, to showcase it also in the virtual realm, which we did here. And Mara will host a guided tour through her space, which is called Domestic Dreams, in about 3 weeks, on the 4th of November. So there will be a second guided tour, and this guided tour will be here in this space, and this space here is called Liminal Latitudes. And it deals very much with the liminal states we had to experience during the crisis in the past month, meaning that in real life we hadn't we did not have the opportunity anymore to meet, to touch each other. We had to distance socially, but these are all things that are actually possible in the virtual world. We can meet here already. Chiara and Mara hugged already here, So there is this possibility to use this space also for social connections. It's maybe not the same like in real life, but it's different, and it's just working in a different way. And the architecture of the space, which was created by Martina Menegon. Martina, are you here now? Yes, okay, perfect. And the architecture derives from a Mozilla Hubs installation of the artist Martina Menegon, on the other hand. And I will ask her in a second to talk more about her work. First, I want to also tell you more about the concept of liminal latitudes and how it is reflected in her architecture. Here you can see the hands all across the space. You can also fly and see much more hands. Over these hands you see now, mm-hmm. And here you can walk through the hands. You cannot touch them. They are not like haptic physical elements. They are just visually there, and when you walk and you can just walk across them. But on the other hand, in this installation, you can walk on water, which you obviously cannot do in real life. So also this exhibition architecture explores the liminality of these different states, and maybe also compares them to the physical states, and also says that many things are possible in both worlds. They will just be different in both worlds, and I think that's a really important notion of this whole show of paradox paradise also. Martina, I would love if you could also add some words about your installation. Would you like to do that? Yeah, so we all go closer to Martina so that we can hug her and hear her.
Hi. Can you hear me?
Yes, beautiful.
Yes. Avatar. Perfect. Yes, thank you. Sorry, I'm a bit late.
No,
I mean, Tina, you already said perfectly a lot about my work. But yeah, the idea was really to for me to take parts of like my virtual reality projects that couldn't be shown due to the pandemic, and kind of find a new place for them or a new version of them. And on the other hand, is an iteration of Keep in Touch, which is a VR work we created in 2019, so last year. And basically what I did was just freeze a frame of these 3D models of the hands that you would be surrounded by in VR. And in this case, they don't move, they're just there. They create a landscape that you can navigate. They create an abstract shape if you want when you fly into them. But they also remind us of body, of touching, of skin, of contact. That of course was something we missed a lot during the pandemic, and actually we still do until today. I really love the combination in this exhibition with the water. Like it becomes something eerie, but at the same time relaxing, or at least for me, it has this this nice combination of two different feelings coming together.
Great. Thank you so much, Martina. That was really, really great. Okay, now I would like to proceed and introduce you the single works of the exhibition. And I would like to start with the work of Chiara Passa. And we will follow Chiara all to her first installation, or just follow me. She has two sculptures, and one of the sculptures is this one here, this abstract. Are you all there? I maybe have to turn around and see you. You're all following me.
Yeah.
Chiara is also here. So come all close to Chiara. Come all close to Chiara.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, Chiara. Do you want to say something about your work?
Yes, thank you. Thank you for inviting me. And I was working on the idea of the void, presenting and exhibiting here two digital sculptures from the series Null Void Zero. The whole series is constituted by several sculptures made in marble, 3D printing, and other materials. Null Void Zero in computer science is the code used in many programming languages to generate color, shape, size of a 3D model of an object. And I was fascinated by the linguistic paradox linked to this formula. So 0.0, which in our Western culture means nothing, in informatics it is the origin of everything. In fact, 0.0 generated in my sculpture the large hole, the void precisely, which is the space, which is the real space to contemplate as an aesthetic. My artistic research since 1997 analyzes differences in between virtual and real space through a variety of techniques, technologies and devices, often using and combining virtual reality and augmented reality as artistic media. So I can say that I use the air to comprise its intrinsic language for shaking up and challenging the aesthetic notion of architecture and place.
Right, and Chiara, can you also tell something about the surface and how you usually deal with surfaces in the digital and the physical, and what is interesting for you about this?
Yes, my intention is to explore the liminal duality between tangible and virtual space, achieving in art a strange oscillation between spaces. And typically, I work with many 3D viewers that are installed all over the space, designing geometric shapes in liminal site-specific areas, where onlookers can peek through the 3D viewers over the wall, over the space, and immerse into a reconstructed, recited VR space made of geometric angles and very strange futuristic views, sometimes semi-open or semi-closed, but highlighting the paradox of the modern space-time condition, which nowadays is even more diluted in between physical and virtual space.
Yes, thank you so much, Chiara. Yes, can you hear me? Chiara,
yeah,
thank you so much. Mille grazie.
Thank you.
Okay, then I will proceed to the next work. I will first start with all the artists who are present here today. Hello, Hannah. To make sure that we all have enough time also to talk about their works. And then I would say we go to Katharina Arndt's work. Right, we already saw this picture here, maybe we just go here, Katharina, to your work here, right? Katharina, can you hear me? Katharina, can you hear me?
Ich höre dich. I hear you.
Yes.
Maybe I'm a bit lost in space. Wir müssen ein bisschen näher kommen.
Where did you... Where... To which work did you go? Where are you?
I'm at the gate. Ah, I see you. Sorry. I'm coming.
Awesome. Yeah, so to let you know, there are two works of Chiara Passa. Like the one we just saw, and on the other side there is this black and white abstract sculpture. It is also Chiara's work. And also Katharina Arndt, she has two works in the space. The one right behind me and the other black and white image, the monumental one right in front of me, but on the other side of the space, where you can see the girl in the white bikini and also taking a selfie. So these are the two works of Katharina. Katharina, do you want to say something about your works?
Of course. Mm-hmm. In original, these are paintings and not in this size. And what's really interesting here is that's so huge and size doesn't matter, so that you can design it and resize it. And in real, I paint on plastic foil with and lacquer
foil. So the topic of the surface is really important. And content-wise, the topic of superficial behavior, social media, and the idea of creating your social surface. So I think it's really a good match here, content-wise, and because the virtual room is just a construction for surface as well. So I like this combination.
Really happy that you like it, because yeah, you I think you haven't been exhibiting your work in a in a virtual space before, right?
No, it's first time, and so it's not especially painted or drawn for it, but I think the selection you did, it's a good match, so it makes sense.
Right. Yeah, I love. I know your works are very physical, and the quality is really strong. So I'm really happy that they also look really great in virtual reality. And I also love that the monumental size.
Yeah.
I love that in the virtual realm, because also I think that's also a topic of your work. That's not only like selfie culture, how we deal with technology, but also you depict strong women. And they have this monumental size, and I like this a lot. But maybe you can tell a little bit more about the kind of women you're interested in depicting in your works.
You can name it a gender topic. And I paint a lot of women with, you can call it like male attributes. They smoke a lot, they drink a lot, this attributes connect us with men. You think about a gentleman, and when it's connected with the woman, it's kind of not so selbstverständlich, not so
common.
Usually in the mainstream media, women are connected with home, inside, smiling, family, and all this. So I like to paint women where the gender pictures are not so clear, and it's kind of on the edge, and it's kind of confusing for both, for women and for men. So I like to play with this. So
I like that.
Yeah.
And I like that this installation coincides with your first mural you painted, right, in Barcelona, which was also like the first real-life monumental version of one of your works, right?
Yeah, I think it's kind of an inspiration here. I have to go bigger.
Yeah, see? In real life, too.
Yes.
Sounds great. Thank you so much, Katharina.
Yeah. Thank you for your invitation.
Okay, then let's go to Ornella Fieres' video work.
Mm-hmm.
Just follow me. Like here. I had it muted. I will just make it the sound on for a second, and then we can talk about it, right?
Where nature and technology intertwine. I dream of a world where the digital space is open to all. I dream of.
Okay, I will just mute the installation for a second, and everyone is here, right? Perfect. Ornella, do you want to introduce your work?
Yes. Hi. So this is my work. It's called I Create Paths That Lead to the Clouds in Which We Go. And the title is made by an artificial intelligence. And so is basically the rest of the video. So it is an artificial intelligence that is talking to us, and it's kind of sharing lots of
hopes and fears, and it's clairvoyant, looking into the future and telling us about humanity and how it's going to evolve.
How did you create the artificial intelligence?
So it's a neural network that I was using, that I was teaching, and I was feeding it with texts that were written about my work within the last decade or so. So I was feeding it with basically my thoughts or thoughts that were written about my work. And my work is about the spiritual and uncanny aspects of the digital. So it is talking, of course, about something uncanny and something spiritual, but it kind of evolved from that and became very dark. So it said a lot of very, very dark things that I also didn't put into this video. It's kind of like a self-fulfilling prophecy, because I was feeding it with stuff about the connection between the digital and the occult, and it became an occult digital thing. Mm. But it was interesting how it just became more, it went far over my theories and said very funny and sad things.
So it kind of exceeded the output you expected. It was even darker than you thought it would be, kind of.
Yeah, or it just said, I'm afraid of dying. And of course, that is nowhere within my text or something. I don't know where that came from, but this is just some things that kept on happening. Yeah,
wow. And the images, where are they from?
So the images, that is a nuclear bomb, as you can see, from the 60s. So I'm always using found material or historical material that was analog at some point, and I'm digitizing it. And I wanted to have something that looks a little bit tacky and a little bit beautiful, but is something very, very dangerous and deathly. And yes, and I think I found the right image for that.
Right, yeah, that's for sure.
Can I ask you, Ornella, the algorithm, do you know where sort of this, is it like one of the default algorithm that you can download on the internet? Biases that are sort of programmed into these.
So it's a neural network that is based on texts like novels or something. Mm-hmm. So this is the framework for this, but I was reading it with my stuff, and how exactly I was doing it, I can't say. Secret.
Are you interested? I mean, you work a lot with the ideas of memory, with the footage, found footage, images that convey a kind of memory for other people also. Why is this interesting for you to work with these kind of materials?
I'm interested in bringing these past moments into the now and seeing what happens if we digitize old analog material or old moments and bring them or transform them into something new. And that is happening now. And then I see, what is still lingering in these moments and what does it teach us for the future, maybe. That's why I'm using the found footage.
Great. Thank you so much, Ornella. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, then I think all the artists, unless Helena Hunter is here. Helena, are you here? No, I guess. If I missed someone, please let me know. Otherwise, I'll proceed and introduce you to the remaining works of the exhibition. And I will just start with this one by Thomas Tollet. And what you can see here is a 3D model of a real-life sculpture of the artist. And the real-life sculpture contained like goggles. It was basically a respiratory system, like a mask, which you could use during corona times, maybe as a doctor or so, to stay safe and sound and have something you can breathe through. And Thomas created this assemblage from trash he found during the lockdown around in his area. And for the exhibition, we asked him to present a 3D model of this sculpture. And you can see that this 3D model here, it's really not perfect. It has a different coloring from the real life. There are holes in it. It looks like kind of a, let's say, trash version of the physical assemblage he created. And this makes also fully sense, because also not only because the sculpture also loses its functionality in the virtual realm. You know, you can't use it here anymore as a respiratory system, which you also don't need, because obviously in the virtual realm it's corona safe, and you don't need this kind of protection here in this virtual realm. So again, the sculpture which he created out of trash also becomes a kind of outdated model in virtual reality. Yes, and then we proceed to the work by Hecht and Lantin. It's just right here, it's the screen here, the small TV, which you can see here. And oh, there's something, and a glitch. No worries. So I hope you can all hear me. Let me check if you're still all behind me. Yes, that's wonderful. And yeah, Hecht and Lantin is a German artist duo. And they recorded from an analog screen, like this news TV presenter, and created a glitch, an abstract glitch out of it. And you have this news TV presenter basically, you know, repeating the news all day, all the bad news. And it starts to get very boring and I'll just show you the sound a little.
Show me how it should be. Tell me, baby, 'cause I need to know now. Oh, because the loneliness is killing. I must confess, I still
so
believe.
You can...
When radio whistle on, I lose my mind.
Oh, I can't read the sound.
They hit me, baby, one more time. Oh, baby, baby, the reason I please is true.
Strange Mark, can you try to mute the sound for if some reason? Killed, there's also like a glitch or so. I don't know what happened here.
I could do.
Now it works, okay. So sorry, I just had problems to mute the video again. But as you can see, the sound is a karaoke version of Britney Spears's One More Time, and that's how it feels to listen to the corona news every day. It's just an endless repetition. And also one of the lines in the song is, my loneliness is killing me. And that's also a state where we may have all been in the past month. And as you can see on these black frames around the video, it is actually a recording of an analog video. And we presented, therefore, this video on a 3D model of an analog TV here in this virtual exhibition. Also, if you have any questions in between, just, you know, let me know. Otherwise, I will proceed to the work by Marie-Ève Levasseur. It's right behind us. It's here. It's... an assemblage, a collage of several 3D models. As you can see here, the grass are part of it, and these two floating objects around it. And you can also go through the grass, as I am doing this now, and look at the objects also from behind, if you want to do this. But you can of course also see them from the front, and you will recognize, you will find out that you can walk through the grass, but you cannot walk through the two objects of Marie-Ève here. And yeah, I just want to go to one of them now and stand in front of them to show you, to better show, be able to show you the visuals. And you can see that Marie-Ève created a digital collage here on this fabrics, well, like 3D object fabrics, where she connected or collected different elements of the digital realm, different elements that also played an important role during the lockdown when we were at home. We basically were just connected to the computer to communicate outside. It was one of the few tactile devices we used, and all the tactile contact mainly worked through the digital technologies and not through hands or like physical, real-life physical elements. And Marie-Ève, she's an artist who generally is very interested in this tactility or haptics of different objects, real-life objects or technological objects. And what happens here with the elements is that the work is called Tactile Cravings, by the way, that on the one hand, you really want to be online to meet your friends, but on the other hand, you're also exhausted, right? These hands here, they look like empty gloves just hanging on across the laptop and not able to work anymore, not able to move anymore because of the exhaustion of this is the only way to communicate during the lockdown. And then let's go to Mila Strakilovic's work, which is right behind me here. It's this video. I will again just
speak to me.
Make the sound a little louder and then mute it and talk
speak
about.
Speak to me. Speak to me. Speak. I think you're below me. I think you're always below me. Like water. Stupid water. Stupid pregnant water, a slimy liquid copy of the sky. How is it over there, underwater? Does it matter?
Yeah, that was a really great sequence to show you in this video. The sequence, the short sequence about the water and its meaning, actually. And that is what this video by Milo Strakilovic, which is the only work which came into existence before the corona crisis here in this space, is about. It questions the meaning of different objects in the digital world and if they have maybe the same, if they even have a meaning in the digital or not. And also, he does this with this white flag. He questions, is this white flag just an object, is just a line in the space, what is the meaning? And on the other hand, this white flag also, of course, symbolizes freedom, right? Freedom that we may not have in real life, but we have in the physical, in the virtual realm at the moment. And in another sequence of this video, you will see the three axes, X, Y, Z, which are basically the axes which, like the coordinate system, which you need to create a 3D space or to create a 3D model. And Milos, he named this three axes Facebook, Google Chrome, and YouTube, you know, to ironically address even before the lockdown, as these are the parameters of our lives where we deal with every day, where our life happens. And this, of course, became much more prevalent during the lockdown, where our digital communication intensified, of course. Okay, then I think the last work is the installation by Helena Hunter. Helena, you're not here yet, right? So this is the work, and I will show you how it's actually meant to be looked at, because it's meant to walk through this installation. You stand in front of the first image, and then in contrast to real life, you can walk through her installation, like I do it now. You can just do it also and continue walking through the installation and also seeing and reading the poems by the artist. And then we meet on the other side. Yeah, and Helena Hunter, she engages with the life cycle of stars, and she likes the idea that such a life cycle of a star or another planet, to phrase it differently, is very long. You know, it can be millions, billions of years. So like it's a time span that we cannot imagine, like with our human brain. And if like a star dies or it distributes dust into the space, and this dust at some point also enters the atmosphere of the Earth and basically falls down on the Earth, as it also does here. You know, you see these particles around you falling down. This is kind of the cosmic dust falling to the Earth here, and this is also the two planets you see in her in her digital collages, is our blue planet, and then this dusty but sparkly version of it on top, which also falls down here. And what I find really interesting about this work is that the concept of time very much varies with the situation we are in and how we feel and what we're doing, you know. And time goes by so fast, or it went by really fast for me when I was flying around the Earth to do my shows in the past years. And this time during the lockdown, and especially the first month of the lockdown, time passed by so slowly and in a pace I wasn't even used. I didn't experience in a long time, and I love to experience this. And I mean, now it accelerated again, everything, but I kind of like this very quiet time also. And in comparison to these 200 million years of a star lifetime, it's just dust. Okay, that was it from my side about this about the space. And before we end the tour, Mara and I would love to invite you to a sneak peek, or you can visit the room anyway, to visit Mara's room of the exhibition Domestic Dreams. And Mara will say just a few words and also remind you of her of the guided tour in 3 weeks on the 4th of November. And so you please all follow me and go to this orange portal here. You know, you see it. And thanks, Martina, thanks for being here. And when you're at this portal, you hover with your mouse, you know, you hover over, or with your controller, you point to the portal, and then open link appears. And then you click on open link and another window opens, and you will go to another hub space. And in this other hub space, we will all meet in a second. See you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Great too, Tina.
Thank you. Thank you so much for joining. It was such a pleasure.
Yeah, welcome to Domestic Dreams. Second space of the exhibition. Are we waiting for more?
Yeah, let's give them a second. There they should be here. Mm-hmm. Ornella and yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Hannah. Ah, and that's Hannah. Hi. Yeah, that's a really beautiful avatar also.
Okay. Water being. I wish we could change our forms like that. Wouldn't it be great?
Yeah, that would like be awesome. Like walk around
the octopus for a day, and the next day some kind of, I don't know, it's a beautiful plant.
Yes, that would be so cool. Okay, should we start, Mara?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not gonna spoil much, but I mean, we've just been to Tina's space, which I think was very much about sort of this which is very much about the liminality of this sort of these months of coronavirus and our usage of digital technologies and these borderline phenomena between physical and digital realms, and the space Domestic Dreams contains artworks that highlights our domestic experiences during the height of the lockdown, and the works will speak of psycho-emotional states. They somehow foreground these escapist moments venturing towards dream states, but then also portray sort of the change of habits in private and public spaces, such as the work of Agnese Sanghito that you see behind you, who's talking about the choreography of queuing, which has almost become a universal language in times of corona, that sort of connects every city at the height of lockdown. You see people queuing almost in the same way on streets before shops and so on. And just a few words about the design. So the design is by the artist Sabine Funke, who is a painter. She's very much interested in working with shapes of color and with form. And she in her design for the space is inspired by the concept of an agora, a central public space, as Tina mentioned earlier, in which people would meet and debate and sort of envision shared futures together. And the idea is that when you go to the center of the space, you can see every artwork. And every artwork, in a way, enters in a dialogue and is connected with each other. And I will speak about these connections more on the 4th of November. So I really hope you will join us for that second part of the tour. And I hope we'll see many of the participating artists too. She's coming. Hannah will be talking about her work. Uli will be there. I'm not sure whether Uli is the squirrel who was there earlier. And I think Lara will be talking about an amazing triptych.
Awesome.
I'll be back for that.
Awesome. Thank you, Mara. Thank you, everyone, for coming. It was such a pleasure. Thank so happy guys. To have you.
See you.
See you.
Thank you. Thanks, everyone. That we can hang out again with each other, right?
Yes. And drink the tonic. Bye. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.